Well, the problem is the man is using words that have no connection to reality. So he says we have a national crisis, a security crisis, a national emergency. I agree we have a national emergency, but the emergency is this president. The emergency is the fact we don't have an executive who's exercising his power in a responsible way.
Well, that was Lawrence Lessig, a Harvard law professor, arguing that the national emergency isn't the US-Mexico border. Trump said he may call it that if he doesn't get the wall. No, the real national emergency is President Trump.
Constitutionally, he wouldn't have the power to do what he claims he wants to do. But the question is, under these statutes, whether he could create enough uncertainty to be able to dislodge the presumption, the very strong presumption, that to build a wall on the border requires an act by Congress, which he's just not going
to
get.
Now, to his credit, Lawrence calls himself a constitutionalist, and he did serve as a clerk for conservative Judge Richard Posner and the late Justice Antonin Scalia. He ran as a Democrat for president in 2016, but dropped out because of insufficient funding. Get this, he actually had some kind words to say about Trump back then, saying Trump might be able to bring about campaign finance reform. But Lawrence isn't the only Harvard professor to make the news lately. Here's Professor Cornel West.
We're losing the sense of we-ness. We're losing the sense of collective project. And we on the left, we're so fragmented that we're unable to come up with a language that is strong enough to create solidarity across the board.
I agree. We're losing our sense of collectiveness as Americans. We're letting illegals invade our country and call themselves undocumented citizens. We're letting cultural Marxism invade our textbooks and call itself scholarly wisdom. We're letting so-called provocative public intellectuals like you invade our Twitter feeds while the social media Stasi purges provocateurs who have the wrong opinions. We need to come together as a collective to fight that. Isn't that what you mean, Cornell?
Well, I think at the present moment, we're seeing the imperial meltdown in the American empire. It takes the form of the relative eclipse of any integrity, honesty, decency, generosity, compassion among the vast majority of those who rule.
Imperial meltdown in the American Empire. Exactly how many colonies do you expect the American king to lose, Cornell? And yes, please preach to me about integrity and compassion. Those are the qualities motivating your employer, Harvard, as it revokes admission offers for memes exchanged in private Facebook group chats, institutes penalties for kids who dare join single-gender frats and sororities, and discriminates against Asian American applicants, allegedly, don't sue me, based on personality traits. Now that is true compassion. For Campus Unmasked, I'm Rob Shimshock. If you like this video and support our mission, please make sure to comment and subscribe. If something happens on your campus and you'd like us to investigate, send us details using the form on campusunmasked.com.